protest was not for anything. It was for the frustrated individuals who have wanted to make it in one way or the other, but they have failed because lack of discipline. Because you need discipline. Even in music, you need discipline. For you to succeed, ask, check Google how many songs J-Lo made before she made it. How many songs this Tanzanian guy, there is that Tanzanian guy who sings, very nice songs, how many songs he did. And here in Zambia, mchisanga mapanga karu mbokamo, but be from waimba karu mbokamo, and you think you have made it, and you want to live big. Mwana mkushtefi wefukuru, which needs a lot of money to look after. Those dogs, some of these dogs are very expensive to look after. They are more expensive than a human being. But you want to have them so that mwone kikwat na mwone pa Hollywood, but wamundu waimba karu mbokamo. You can't. Those guys work very, very hard. It requires discipline, it requires hard work. But you want free things, you want shortcuts. It doesn't work. It doesn't work. And there you are claiming for freedom of expression, freedom of expression. Who is stopping you to speak? Who is stopping you to speak? But before you said, I'm very hungry, you went. So in social media, I'm very hungry. You know, this country, things are not going right. Yeah, there is corruption, point at corruption. I'm not saying there is no corruption in this country, there is corruption, but when you want to accuse people, when you want to talk about corruption, be very specific that here there is corruption. And don't talk about things which are not true. Don't talk about 48 houses, because the 48 houses, there is the owner who is in court fighting for those houses. So don't say those 48 houses, there is no owner. The 48 houses, there is the owner who has come and he has sued the Anti-Corruption Commission. Don't talk about the ambulances when you have not even reviewed how the tender went, and you don't even know the real cost, because the 288 that you talk about is not the cost. Those ambulances cost about $135,000, and you check on the internet the fixtures in those ambulances, how much they cost. So some of these things that you talk about, really, you speak out of ignorance. You speak out of ignorance. But the freedom of expression that is in this country allows you to speak freely like that on things that are not true. So you are claiming for freedom of expression. Now, here comes a woman who has made herself Stella Sata. She may be a Sata, but she's a unique person. She's a young lady that has made herself. Even when Sata was there, she stood out unique. She stood out as a brilliant person, as an intelligent young lady. When you look at Stella Sata, she has not jumped on any opportunity or privileges that she had as a daughter of a president. She has created herself. She's doing a lot in business, encouraging entrepreneurship, making so much sense. I mean, when I look at Stella Sata, she's in the league of, you know, she's a Dambisa Moyo of our future. In the future, when you look at Stella Sata, that young lady will be as successful as Dambisa Moyo. You can't attribute the success of Dambisa Moyo to anybody else. She could have been a president, she could have been a president's daughter, but she made herself. And that's what Stella Sata has done. And all she asked is a very valid question. The youths are hungry, but who are they hungry against? And for what? And those are very valid questions. You are hungry. Yes, you are hungry. For who? Against who? Against who? And for what? What is it that has made you hungry in this country for you to start protesting? What is it? And against who? How has this government stopped you from taking those opportunities which are there? How has it stopped you? So how can you be angry against the government when the opportunities are there for you to grab? And what are you really upset about? What are you upset about? Those questions are very genuine, coming from a very intelligent person. I don't know if you call yourself intelligent when you start insulting her, when you start talking about her background, when you start talking about her family, when some of you can't even manage families. The heroes that you are celebrating, they failed to manage their own families. So I think it is very, very unfair, and I find it quite concerning, because you know, this is a woman, this is a family person that young people and other disgruntled people are wallowing insults on. It's not fair. If you want freedom of expression, you must also give it to Stella Sat. You must also allow her to speak. A number of times Stella Sat have said something that I don't agree with, but I respect her opinion. You want to protest, and Stella Sat doesn't see the reason to protest, and she asks you a question. Instead of responding to her, you start insulting her. Are you making sense? Is that objective? Is that the democracy that we talk about? And no wonder you usually say that Edgar Lungu really has, you know, the goodness of Edgar Lungu has allowed a lot of people to misbehave. I'm telling you, the goodness of Edgar Lungu has allowed a lot of people to misbehave at different levels of life, and especially those on social media. You mock Edgar Lungu, you make pictures, you do what on Edgar Lungu. And yet, you get away with it. You can't get away with the nonsense that you put up on social media. You know, defaming the head of state. Yesterday I was even hearing a useless song. Defaming the head of state. Making fun of the head of state. But Edgar Lungu doesn't. And mind you, he showed you that day that he actually reads what goes on social media. And you get away with it. And some of you think that, you know, they can't find you. They can't find you. You are busy on social media with your name there, with your profile there. And even if you make pseudo accounts, it is not difficult these days. I mean, the mobile that you are using, the talk time that you are using, the internet that you are using is connected to your phone. It's connected to your phone. Wherever you are, there is an IP which can lead, you know, somebody to find you right into your bedroom where you are. It doesn't matter where you are. You can be tracked. But, you know, like I'm saying, the goodness of Edgar Lungu really messes you up. So from my point of view, I mean, I'm very disappointed. I'm very disappointed with those who want to mess up the profile of our country. Because when you are coming up with these, protests and false accusations, you are messing up the profile of the country. And as you are messing up the profile of the country, you are causing investor flight. And that's not good. Perceptions, negative perception on a country, they don't help.